Ezetimibe is a cholesterol absorption inhibitor used to lower total cholesterol, LDL-C, Apo-B, and non-HDL-C in primary hyperlipidemia and familial cholesterolemia. In this video, let's find found. What is ezetimibe? What is ezetimibe used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking ezetimibe? How does ezetimibe work? How to use ezetimibe? What is ezetimibe? Ezetimibe is a medication used to treat high blood cholesterol and certain other lipid abnormalities. Generally, it is used together with dietary changes and a statin. Alone, it is less preferred than a statin. It is taken by mouth. Ezetimibe was approved for medical use in the United States in 2002. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 100th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 7 million prescriptions. What is ezetimibe used for? Ezetimibe is indicated to reduce elevated total C, LDL-C, Apo-B, and non-HDL-C in patients with primary hyperlipidemia, alone or in combination with an HMG-CoA reductase inhibitor, statin. It is also indicated to reduce elevated total LDL-C, Apo-B, and non-HDL-C in patients with mixed hyperlipidemia in combination with fenofibrate, and to reduce elevated total C and LDL-C in patients with homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, HoFH, in combination with atorvastatin or simvastatin. Ezetimibe may also be used to reduce elevated cytosterol and campesterol in patients with homozygous cytosterolemia, phytosterolemia. Contraindication. The two contraindications to taking ezetimibe are a previous allergic reaction to it, including symptoms of rash, angioedema, and anaphylaxis, and severe liver disease, especially when taken with a statin. Ezetimibe may have significant medication interactions with cyclosporin and with fibrates other than fenofibrate. Side effects. Common adverse drug reactions, greater than or equal to 1% of patients, associated with ezetimibe therapy include headache and or diarrhea, steatorrhea. Infrequent adverse effects, 0.1 to 1% of patients, include myalgia and or raised liver function test, ALT/AST, results. Rarely, less than 0.1% of patients, hypersensitivity reactions, rash, angioedema, or myopathy may occur. Cases of muscle problems, myalgia, and rhabdomyolysis have been reported and are included as warnings on the label for ezetimibe. Since NPC1L1 also regulates vitamin K uptake, the use of ezetimibe can lead to side effects in warfarin therapy. Pharmacodynamic. Ezetimibe was shown to reduce the levels of total cholesterol, total C, low-density lipoprotein cholesterol, LDL-C, apoprotein B, Apo-B, non-high-density lipoprotein cholesterol, non-HDL-C, and triglycerides, TG, and increase high-density lipoprotein cholesterol, HDL-C, in patients with hyperlipidemia. This therapeutic effect was more profound when ezetimibe was co-administered with a statin or fenofibrate compared to either treatment alone. In clinical trials involving patients with homozygous and heterozygous familial hypercholesterolemia and in those with cytosterolemia, a recommended therapeutic dose of ezetimibe was effective in reducing the LDL levels by 15 to 20% while increasing HDL-C by 2.5 to 5%. The effects of increased exposure to ezetimibe secondary to moderate severe hepatic impairment have not been assessed. Patients meeting these criteria should avoid the ezetimibe. Post-marketing reports indicate the potential for myopathy and rhabdomyolysis in patients taking ezetimibe, and this risk appears to be exacerbated in patients concurrently receiving, or having recently received, statin therapy. Mechanism of action. Ezetimibe mediates its blood cholesterol-lowering effect via selectively inhibiting the absorption of cholesterol and phytosterol by the small intestine without altering the absorption of fat-soluble vitamins and nutrients. The primary target of ezetimibe is the cholesterol transport protein niemann-pick 1, like 1, NPC1L1, protein. NPC1L1 is expressed on enterocytes/gut lumen, apical, as well as the hepatobiliary, canalicular, interface and plays a role in facilitating internalization of free cholesterol into the enterocyte in conjunction with the adaptor protein 2, AP2 complex and clathrin. Once cholesterol in the gut lumen or bile is incorporated into the cell membrane of enterocytes, it binds to the sterol sensing domain of NPC1L1 and forms a NPC1L1/cholesterol complex. The complex is then internalized or endocytosed by joining to AP2, forming a vesicle complex that is translocated for storage in the endocytic recycling compartment. Ezetimibe does not require exocrine pancreatic function for its pharmacological activity, rather, it localizes and appears to act at the brush border of the small intestine. Ezetimibe selectively blocks the C1L1 protein in the jejunal brush border, reducing the uptake of intestinal lumen micelles into the enterocyte. Overall, ezetimibe causes a decrease in the delivery of intestinal cholesterol to the liver and reduction of hepatic cholesterol stores and an increase in clearance of cholesterol from the blood. While the full mechanism of action of ezetimibe in reducing the entry of cholesterol into both enterocytes and hepatocytes is not fully understood, one study proposed that ezetimibe prevents the NPC1L1/sterol complex from interacting with AP2 in clathrin-coated vesicles and induces a conformational change in NPC1, rendering it incapable of binding to sterols. Another study suggested that ezetimibe disrupts the function of other protein complexes involved in regulating cholesterol uptake, including the CAV1, annexin 2 heterocomplex. Half-life. Both ezetimibe and ezetimibe glucuronide display an approximate half-life of 22 hours. Dose. Homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia. 10 mg POQ day in combination with atorvastatin or simvastatin. Homozygous cytosterolemia. 10 mg POQ day adjunctive to diet. Primary hyperlipidemia. 10 mg POQ day in combination with HMG-CoA reductase inhibitors adjunctive to diet. Safety advice. Pregnancy category C. There are no adequate and well-controlled studies of ezetimibe in pregnant women. Ezetimibe should be used during pregnancy only if the potential benefit justifies the risk to the fetus. That's all the information about ezetimibe we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.